うるさく
Yeah, that was weird. Hey everyone, it's me, Leon, and today I bring you...
What happened?
Okay, today I bring you news about Yu-Gi-Oh! Yu-Gi-Oh! In this case, bring you information about Yu-Gi-Oh! As we are about to start Yu-Gi-Oh! Stuff. Yeah, plenty. So we actually will be stepping into Yu-Gi-Oh! Territory at this point. So we will have fight videos and stuff like that, and make things as interesting as they can, same just like our Vanguard videos. First things first, we would like to talk about the new Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime called Yu-Gi-Oh! Reigns. Anyways, the new protagonist is called Okay, the new protagonist's name is called Yusaku. Okay, so basically Yusaku is the new protagonist for this upcoming series. I know the name is awkward. So anyways, he's the new protagonist for the new upcoming Yu-Gi-Oh! Series. And this time round, they're treading into new territory with new zones and new everything else, but we're gonna go through the anime for now. For the anime, a lot of things is happening. First things first, we talk about Yusaku. He looks like Luat that went to high school in a way due to the look of his hair. We'll look wherever Cat decided to understand. Basically, his hair color, it reminds you of Luat a lot due to the color combination. However, when he goes into the dueling world, basically, the system changed. Apparently, right now, the information we're given so far is that he go into virtual reality world, and then they do hoverboard stuff. So they went from Olympics, from Arc 5 to Tony Hawk Pro Skater. Can I get my motorcycle back? So, okay, as most of the protagonists for Yu-Gi-Oh! Series, he also have a supporting character, some organism thing, at least that's what the information was given on the Shonen Jump. And it's not stated what kind of organism is this, but it's just something supporting him, like Yugi has his sexy, half-naked pharaoh and the crimson dragon for Yusei, yada yada, and you know. Okay, now we'll talk about the new mechanics for this game. Basically what happens to Yu-Gi-Oh! Right now is that there's a lot of changes. The field entirely changed in a way, is that, okay, for those who already are playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Or recently started within these few years, you know that the field itself has the Pendulum Zone, Monster Zone, Magic Trap, Extra Deck, you know, the usual stuff. It's just things add on to the field, but now what they did with the entire field is that Pendulum Zone is now in the Magic Trap, which is on the two ends, the far left and the far right. As for Extra Deck monsters, why did I mention about that is that right now they have a new zone called the Extra Monster Zone, which is there's only two zones of that in the center, kind of like Vanguard's Guardian Circle, but it's not the Guardian Circle. And when you summon monsters from the Extra Deck, it goes into that zone immediately. Basically, you can no longer spam summon as what you have always been doing if you play like Pendulum Summoning, Xyz Summoning, stuff like that. So long it comes from the Extra Deck, it goes straight into that zone. And when occupying that zone, the other zone will automatically go to your opponent. When you spell summon monsters from the Extra Deck zone, it will go straight into that zone and occupying the extra monster zone. So you cannot have a full field of Junk Warrior or things. But why is that? Why the complication? Because I believe, at least from my perspective, is that they're trying to balance out everything again. They're trying to set everything back into its place in a way that there's some control. Like, they no longer can spam summoning, and that's not fun half the time for extra deck monsters.
No control, like the sound outside.
Yeah, oops. They want to like balance things out once again because right now what's happening onto the Yu-Gi-Oh! Main game is that everybody just spam summons, and then usually there's no breathing space for the other player. That's usually what happens. It's like they just Xyz, and it's carry on. So maybe they're trying to balance things out again and try to reshape the game once again and giving it new experience of game. So maybe there will be new formats in the future as well. As for The Link Monster, as I just talked about, which is basically the new mechanics for this series now, is that these monsters are very special. They don't have levels. What happens is that these monsters can only be special summoned by using material that total up to the number of effect monsters or Link Monster as materials. And depending on how many links the monster represents. Okay, if you look at the card, okay, the card has attack power. Stated there, like for example, the main Yusaku's new main protagonist card, the Decode Talker. The power is 2-3, 2,300. Okay, it has Link 3, so basically you need 2 or more effect monsters to summon this guy, or you need monsters that has Link 2 or 1 to summon to total up the number of links to special summon from your extra deck. And it goes into the extra monster zone. If you look at the card, the monsters now has this border and have arrows pointing all different directions. It points there, and those that lights up is where the monster is linked to. And those monsters that link to it, that occupies it. So for example, like say, the Decode Talker is 2 on both the left and right arrow, and then 1 in the front arrow. So what happens is that the cards that is linked to it are now part of, it's not part of him. It's linked to him. So whatever skill he uses, it will affect the monsters that is in that zone. That includes your opponent, at least from my understanding, is that it includes your opponent. So for example, the 2 at the from the bottom is yours. Okay, so they are linked to him for skill. And then the 1 in front is actually pointing to one of your opponent's monsters. That monster would probably also be one of the materials used that is connected to him. Unless the monster switches position or something like that. Which for now we do not know. Something around like that, as from understanding or reading the rules. So now, let's talk more about Decode Talker, which is Yusaku's main monster. So what happens is that, okay, he has some, his skill is, when this card is, this card plus 500 attack power for each monster that's linked to him. And he's a Cyber Dark type. By the way, Cyber types are new archetypes for the game now. So it's probably the main character's new archetype like, itself, just for him. Then his second ability, which is, which is quite typical nowadays, is that he gets to negate the ability. So what happens is that when an opponent activates a card ability that basically targets a card you control, you can use his ability, you can tribute one of your monsters that's linked to him, or tribute one of the monsters that's linked to him, probably even your opponent, you can tribute it, and then negate the activation and destroy it. So it's kind of nice, but it's also kind of like a staple skill nowadays, so I guess it's kind of okay. It's actually quite interesting to start now that straight away an ace monster with ability like that, which is actually quite threatening in more ways than one. As for when the starter deck is releasing, it's on the 25th March. It's releasing in Japan. I don't know about Singapore, but it should be around the same time, usually. At the same time, as for the anime, it's somewhere in spring, so it's between March and April, around there. At least that's what Kat told me, so if it's wrong, you can go and find him on the Discord chat. So yeah, he was all told me that. And that's all for today, and if you are looking forward to see more stuff that we have in store for you, like Yu-Gi-Oh! Stuff, which is probably soon, but probably we're starting together when we receive the trial deck and stuff like that, somewhere in March. Or Vanguard stuff, BOSI, which is what we are focused at the moment, do follow us and subscribe. The subscribe button is at the bottom. Yeah, go and click on that. At the same time, you can follow us on all our socials, like Facebook, Twitter, at CrossboneVGS, our blog, Crossbone Vanguards. At the same time, our Discord, we'll be looking forward to talk to you and all the stuff. And of course, do consider supporting us on Patreon, because we will, if you like to see the upcoming, or at least we're trying to make, the Vanguard web series, please do support us. We really could use all the help we can get. So that's it. Thanks for watching and looking at me fail so horribly. We'll see you in the next video. Bye!